Showcase. This showcase is sponsored by the SUI Library Systems, which includes Arrowhead Library System, Bridges Library System, Kenosha County Library System, Lakeshore's Library System, Milwaukee County Federated Library System, and Monarch Library Systems. My name is Jenny Schomber. I'm head of library services at Beloit Public Library, and I will be your MC for this session. All attendees will be muted and your webcams are turned off. Chat has also been disabled so that you can just relax, sit back, and view the demonstrations without any interruptions. If you do have any problems or questions, please submit those in the Q&A box, and you can find that box either in the lower portion of your screen if you're using a computer, or the upper portion of your mobile device if you're using a phone or a tablet. Just to let you know, all sessions will be recorded and they will be made available on YouTube for a limited time. You will find the YouTube link in your program booklet. For your convenience, in the chat box, we will be posting a link to a view-only copy of the program booklet. And please note that that viewable copy is only available during the performer showcase sessions over these 3 days. The recordings will be available beginning on November 22nd, and you can view them through June 1st of next year. The link for that is also provided in your booklet. So today, we have three performers that we're showcasing in this hour. They are Spoon Man, the Traveling Lantern Theater Company, and Jeremy Bryan of the Figureheads. Each performer will have up to 10 minutes to provide a sample performance and then up to 5 minutes to answer your questions. And please, you can submit those questions by typing them into the Q&A box. And then at the end of the performance, I will read those questions to the performers. So with that, we are going to begin our showcase session today. Our first performer is Spoon Man. Music, comedy, and spoons. I mean, come on, what else could you ask for? Spoon Man's fun-filled interactive comedy performances are for families of all ages, and you can find more information about Spoon Man on page 43 of your showcase booklet. And with that, I will be turning it over to Spoon Man. You can take it away. I'll turn off my video. Thanks.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Jenny. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, you've had lunch. Now it's time to wake up. Maybe that's why they had me here right after lunch. So, well, we can talk about silverware too, but and eating and all that kind of fun stuff. But ladies and gentlemen, my name is Jim Cruz. I am known as the Spoon Man, and I'm a professional spoon player. What I use are two ordinary household tablespoons, and I use these spoons as a musical instrument, a rhythm instrument, or a percussion instrument. Now, a lot of people have asked me, Jim, where in the world did you ever get the idea to play the spoons? Well, when I was 9 years old, I wanted a drum set. My mom and dad wouldn't buy me one. So one day I saw my grandpa playing the spoons and I said, wow, grandpa, that's pretty cool. So I went to the kitchen drawer, pulled out a pair of spoons, turned on the radio, and I used to pretend that these spoons were like a drum set. And I would practice and practice and practice and practice. What I would like to do this afternoon to wake us all up is to start out by playing some music, some contemporary music, some popular music, just to give you an idea what spoon playing is all about. Here we go. I'm guessing some of you might recognize this song. Okay, I can tell you guys were not that impressed. You want to see something dangerous, don't you? Well, all right. You have seen a spoon player before. You are now going to see a fork player. Normally, the audience cheers and applause because they've never seen a fork player before. Let's hear it virtually. That's good. All right. And if this is not dangerous enough for you, I am also going to show you a razor sharp butter knife player. Thank you. And because I don't know the meaning of fear, I am also going to show you a pie server player with serrated edges. I brought my whole kitchen drawer here for you folks. I'm holding nothing back other than the pie. And that's upstairs for after the show. All right. I'm going to do a little bluegrass song now to mix it up a little bit. Bluegrass and kitchen utensils go together really well. You folks can help me out too. When I pull out my different silverware, let's say for instance, the spoons, you would yell out Spoon Man. Let's try it. Spoon Man, good. Right? Ha! Fork Man, good. Ha! Not Butter Knife Man. Razor Sharp Butter Knife Man. Let's try that one again. Ha! Good. And ha! Pie Server Man. All right, here we go. A little bluegrass arm. It's getting queued up right now. Yes, here we go. All right. You guys clap along with me. We're going on a little train ride, a silverware train ride. Thank you. Okay. I need a little drink after that one. All right. I also do virtual programming. And what a perfect way to do virtual programming, because what I do with my virtual programming is I do half of my show and then I do half of a workshop. So what makes it wonderful is that the kids can go right to their kitchen drawer, pull out a pair of spoons, and I'm going to teach them how to play. That's part of my virtual programming. All my virtual shows start out at $300. Two shows booked the same day drops down to $200. Three shows booked the same day, $175 per show. So if any of you have any questions, I'm ready, Jenny.
All right, thank you. So my very first question is, how many times did you stab yourself with the forks when you first started learning to use the forks?
I'm embarrassed to show you the pants I'm wearing right now. I've got tiny holes right here.
Oh, I bet.
Yeah, I don't know if you can see that or not.
Yeah. Well, I was also wondering, like, how bruised your legs end up being at the end of a performance.
Well, you know what? When you play, you don't really have to hit yourself hard. It's just a tap. It sounds loud because of the microphone. But that being said, I do get black and blue, especially when I'm performing outdoors, which I also do. But it's just a mental thing. I'm thinking I'm outside, so I have to hit myself harder.
So. Sure, sure. If anybody has any questions, I don't see any in the Q&A box at the moment. So I will just ask, it sounds like, you know, you said that if you have more than three libraries booking or more than three shows in a day, the price comes down. But would you also be open to libraries collaborating with other libraries? So if they were close in distance to each other, would you be open to doing that sort of either virtual or in-person performance?
Well, yeah, virtual, it doesn't matter. I mean,
right.
If I can do three in a day, that it's $175 per show.
Okay.
As far as physically being there, yes, I will work with you. It's $500 for one, it's $400 each for two, and $300 each for three. As long as I can do the programs on the same day, and I don't care if I have to drive 2 hours to get to the other libraries, I just need to be able to do them on the same day.
Sure, sounds good. All right, well, I think that is all that we had for questions. So thank you very much, Spoon Man. And with that, we will move on to our next performer. So if you want to go ahead and turn your camera off, thank you.
Thanks, Lori. Thanks, Angela.
Okay, so our second performer, Traveling Lantern Theater Company, offers live and virtual performances ranging from Sherlock Holmes and Ebenezer Scrooge to Legends from Mount Olympus and Lewis and Clark. Their programs are for kids ages 5 to 13, and you can find more information about them on page 44 in your showcase booklet. And with that, I will turn it over to Traveling Lantern Theater Company. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. I am not nearly as exciting as Spoon Man. I'm just the managing director. Hello from Portland, Oregon. I hope you guys are well. I just wanted to start by thanking Angela, Lori, Meg, and the whole staff for putting this together. What a lot of work it must have been, and boy, it's saving us greenhouse gases. So since that is my hobby, working on climate change legislation, I just want to say thank you so very much for this. I hope we can continue it in the future. So I'm just going to give you a little bit of information about our shows and our plans through summer of next year. Then we have a 4-minute video, which has some clips from some of our shows to show you, and then I'll take questions and answers. So first of all, how COVID affected us. Obviously, we realized that we're an interactive theater company, that we were going to have to figure something else out. So we decided to do virtual programming, which basically means putting our shows on video. We're unable to do live virtual performances, meaning having our actors perform live, because it would have put them in jeopardy. We rehearsed with masks on, and we just took the masks off on shooting day, on filming day, and we've been able to keep everybody safe and healthy because of it. So our shows are on video. We've kept as much of the interaction as possible. The actors will speak directly to the children and ask them to involve themselves in the shows, depending upon which show and what the situation is. But the wonderful thing about doing this is we've been able to make some improvements to our shows that we couldn't normally do. You know, because we travel, we have to have everything able to fold up and travel and fit into a suitcase, and we can't have things that are very elaborate or complicated. So we've been able to do much more elaborate costumes and props while still keeping our regular format and our background as usual, which is just a small stage with two drops and a curtain in the center. We've also been able to add animation, which is really fun. We're really having a good time with that. Our Lewis and Clark show and our Scrooge show are going to be highly animated. So that's very exciting. We're learning how to do that. And we still have some children in our shows, as we always have children come up and perform. We have two volunteer children who have helped us out with some of the shows that we've filmed. And we're happy to be able to have them still in it. So as Jenny was saying, we have six shows: Legends and Myths from Mount Olympus, Sherlock Holmes Takes the Case, The Caterpillar Hunter, Lewis and Clark, and The Story of Scrooge. And those are all available now. In the spring, we will be adding My Mother the Astronaut. So that'll be coming around February 28th, I believe. Our age range is still the same, K through sixth grade age children. Some of our shows lean high, some of them lean low within that group, and we'll be happy to talk with you about your particular needs and what we suggest. But Scrooge in particular is for the whole family. And with this particularly bleak holiday season coming up, we wanted to make sure that we had something to help keep those kids who are going to be locked at home without their grandparents happy during this upcoming season. So let's see. All right. Our shows are averaging 35 to 40 minutes. Usually we have a Q&A after. We do not have a Q&A with these, but they're averaging 35 to 40 minutes. And this is how our virtual programming works. For $150, you purchase a key. The key is good for 1 week, from Sunday to Sunday, for unlimited viewing for all of the kids in one branch or one school. The key can be sent by email out to the kids or the teachers or librarians, however you want to do that. Or it can be printed out on a flyer. If you have curbside service, we have a flyer that will come with the contract that you can just pull off, put on your desktop, and you can print that out or email it out, depending upon what works better for your situation. We also have photos that you can use to advertise the show available on our website. When you call me, I'll show you how to get those. The good thing about our virtual program is that it's flexible. You can either show it to a group if you can gather a group at the library. You can put it on a Zoom call if you have, say, a summer reading program group or any other kind of group that you want to watch it at the same time. Or you can send the key home and the kids can watch it on their own whenever they want to during that period. So even if your situation looks like this now, but COVID comes along and changes it later, this will be flexible and work with whatever plans you have. You will not have to drop it. You can just change the format. So also I wanted to talk with you about our summer plans. We are, especially with this fabulous news about the vaccine that came out yesterday, we are planning on a summer tour. And we are taking bookings now. We have a new show that we're building to fit both the iRead and CLSP themes called Tale of the Rainbow Lizard. There's more information about it on our website. It's being written right now. So the information I can give you is the blurb that is on our website. We are taking bookings for that now. If you want to look for a date, hold a date, book it in. We are well aware that things may change and we may have to make adjustments, but now's the time to get your date if you want to start planning that. And then the good thing will be we will have a virtual version of it as well, so that you can turn it into a virtual show. God forbid, should COVID re-hit during the summer, you can keep your slot, you can keep your week, you can just do a virtual show instead. So with that, we have a little 4-minute video right now that we're going to play, which is just a sampling of some of the stuff we've been doing with our video shows. And then afterwards, I will take any questions and show you where you can go to print out a brochure. Thank you so much.
Accept gold or cash, no checks. There you have it, my fellow Americans. The Louisiana Purchase. It's ours. We need to learn about the land. How do we do that? Well, what's the first step?
Explore it.
I know. We'll explore it to find out what we have. What's next?
Map it.
Ta-da! We made a map.
Oh, America, America, for spacious skies and amber waves of grain, for purple mountains' majesty above the fruited plain. It's pretty good. I should write that down. Hey, Meriwether. Remind me to write myself a letter.
This happens to be none other than the diary of the Queen of England.
No, not Queen Victoria.
Only a Queen Elizabeth the First.
Oh, yes, what? A clue. The reason we are here is because the last known location of Queen Elizabeth's diary was here at the archives. Someone here must know something. Oh, behind us. She must be the head librarian.
We're here to inquire about your fiancé, Mr. Henry Higgins Heathcliff.
Here you go, monsieur. A nice cup of tea.
Thank you.
The story goes like this. King Midas did a favor for the god Dionysus, who was so pleased with the king that he offered him any reward he wished. The king wished that anything he touched would be turned to gold. Reluctantly, Dionysus granted the wish.
Morpheus, the god of dreams, said to her,
"Well, wife, look. Your husband is here. Is my face changed in death?"
And then Icarus became overconfident in his skills of flying and soared away from his father.
Woohoo!
He was having too much fun flying to remember his father's warning.
Oh, I have my story. Praise Zeus!
Zeus!
Christmas to you all!
All right.
Thank you.
Okay. So thank you for the video. And it looks like we don't have any questions in the Q&A box. You were very thorough and answered just about everything, I think, when you were talking about your information. Go ahead.
I do have one or two more things just quickly. The choppiness that you saw while you were watching that, depending upon your broadband situation, if you are running our Vimeo stream through a Zoom call, it can be choppy. So I just wanted to let you know that that is not the way the actual clip is. You can go onto the website, push the button that says clip here to watch a clip and see how it will actually play. Going through the double system sometimes causes that choppiness. And the other thing I just wanted to let you know is that if you'd like a brochure with descriptions of each of these shows, please go to our website, go to the Our Plays page, click on Midwest, and at the top, there's a button you can click and it'll print out for you. Thank you so very much.
Thank you very much. I just had one quick question for myself personally, wondering of all the programs that you offer, which one is the most popular with libraries or most popular that people book?
It depends on the area, I have to say, and it depends on the age group you're trying to. All of these shows are popular. Honestly, I'm not saying that just because, sure. But they are, it really, because they're all so very different and have such different subject matter. I have to say that our Story of Scrooge is the one show that patrons will not let us. They will not let us not have that show. So I would have to say Scrooge is probably of all of them the most popular.
All right, wonderful. Well, thank you very much. And with that, we will move on to our third and final performer for this session. And that is Jeremy Bryan of the Figureheads. He is a Parents' Choice Gold Award-winning storyteller and musician. His performances are for kids ages 3 to 18 and their families. And you can find more information about Jeremy on page 22 of your showcase booklet. And with that, I will be turning it over to Jeremy. And I believe Jeremy has a special guest with him today.
I do indeed. Hello, everyone. My name is Jeremy, and this is my daughter, Lucy. As a traveling and performing artist, I like to mentor younger artists, and Lucy is a gifted performer in her own rights, and we're working on a song that we're gonna share with you today. It'll be the debut. Now, I've done work and written albums for every age group, tailored to the developmental stages of growing up. So, I've written an elementary school album, a middle school album, high school album, and even just for the grown-ups. Well, for everyone, but grown-ups as the focus. And so with that range of understanding, know that I'll do a very age-specific performance for your crew. And we're gonna start with one that we do for little ones called the Stretching Song. And this involves a simple dance, so wherever you're at, you're welcome to join us. It's just hands up high, all the way down to tippy toes if you can reach them. A little movement of the hands like this, and then a turnaround, and then you'll be right where you need to be. Getting back, get the blood flowing, get your body in a just right place for the rest of the day. All right, this is called the Stretching Song. You ready? One, two, three.
From the top fingertips down to tippy toes.
See if you can reach them.
That's the way it is, and that's the way it goes.
So put your hands up high,
get your feet down low.
Now turn around with a little bit of style.
You'll be ready to go.
Hey. All right, now fetch it up and at them. Stretch to your toes and grab them. Now hold them for a moment and then forget that you have them. Cause now you're reaching up and you've got nothing to touch. Unless you're super tall or else the ceiling's low enough. Look at you, you're growing up. You know what to do. You got this routine down. Hey y'all, this ain't nothing new. Now think of this as a way to start a whole nother day. To show everyone in the library how much you love to play. Now, I'm willing to bet you're all excellent stretchers. Put your arms up, put your legs out next. Yes, yes, you're doing just fine. And soon you're gonna find that stretching is the best pretty much any time. From the top fingertips down to tippy toes. That's the way it is and that's the way it goes. Put your hands up high, get your feet down low. And turn around with a little style.
Hey,
alright, now that our limbs are looser, we can begin to do stuff like picking out our clothes and brushing all of our toothers. Yeah, drinking orange juice to quench our thirsties at breakfast. But check it first, things first, let's take a look at our checklist. Number one's already done, cause I did a bunch of stretching. Number two I need to do, open up the blinds and let in the sun. Or whatever weather's out there in the air. Now number three, that's to see what kind of clothes I should wear. Yeah, sometimes if you need a little help with this part and you gotta go to the bathroom really, really bad, then take a break. Yeah, that's number four. Now number five is to celebrate that we're all alive from deep down in our hearts to way up high. Y'all ready? From the top fingertips down to tippy toes. That's the way it is and that's the way it goes. Put your hands up high, get your feet down low, and
pretty soon, little kiddo, you'll be ready to go. It goes, ooh, ooh, child. Everybody just get on down. We can wiggle and wiggle around. Maybe even fall down on the ground. I say, ooh, ooh, child. It's a fun and sunny day. Let's stretch out and go play. Maybe get a snack on the way. I say, ooh, ooh, child. Let's do it all again. Everybody high five a friend. Do your thing and stretch and bend. I say, ooh, ooh, child. Let's do it one more again. Everybody say what's up to a friend. Do your thing. Let's stretch and bend. From a top fingertips down to tippy toes. That's the way it is, and that's the way it goes. Put your hands up high, get your feet down low, and turn around with a little bit of style, and you'll be ready one more time. From the top fingertips down to tippy toes. That's the way it is, and that's the way it goes. Put your hands up high, get your feet down low, and turn around with a little bit of style, and you'll be ready to go.
All right. Excellent. So once you get your body in a good place, get your blood flowing, then you're in a really great spot for your mind to come alive, to come awake. And so this next song is a brand new song, never before performed, and it's called Born to Shine, and we've written it for the Children's Hospital here in Wisconsin. And so this song is going to be with a lot of kids and a lot of curriculums throughout some schools in the area. We're beaming in from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, by the way. So here we go. We are going to perform that song for the first time. And it's all about taking deep breaths and getting your body and your mind in a great place to learn and relate. All right, let's give it a try. By Born to Shine. One, two, three.
We are the dreamers. Wake up and see us. We are the ones who were born to shine with hearts full of hope and healthy minds. We are the dreamers. Wake up and see us. We are the ones who were born to shine with hearts full of hope and healthy minds. Take a deep breath now. You can do it. In, then out. Take a deep breath in tune with the music. In through the nose and out through the mouth. Have you ever had a dream about what you want to be? Things you want to do? Places you want to see? Do you share those thoughts with your family? Or write them in your journal like Dear Diary? When my mind is buzzing like bees in a hive, and I have lots of thoughts at the same time, I pick one thing that I'm thankful for. Like fresh air coming through an open door, or sunlight shining through a gap in the clouds, or a song that I love and can sing out loud. Then I dance around till I'm out of breath. Then I take a rest and I get refreshed, because we are the dreamers. Wake up and see us. We are the ones who were born to shine with thoughts full of hope and healthy minds. We are the dreamers. Wake up and see us. We are the ones who were born to shine with hearts full of hope and a healthy mind. Now take a deep breath. You can do it. In, then out. Take a deep breath in tune with the music. In through the nose and out through the mouth. Have you ever had a feeling that was too big to share? And you might have wondered how it even got there? And it made you mad, sad, or scared? And you had the thought, does anybody care? Well, you're not alone. You're part of a crew. It's a common thing. It's not just you. Yeah, it's a human thing we all go through. So find a safe person that you can talk to. Cause mama always said there'd be days like this when your feelings and thoughts are tied in a knot and you're not sure how to untangle a twist. Well, here's a couple things I was taught. Ready? Take a quick walk. Take a quick break. Come back to it with a fresh mind state. Some things can wait if you're feeling frustrated. You can take a break and come back to it later. When I fall down, I get up again. Take a deep breath and I count to 10. Yeah, take a belly breath. In and out. In through the nose and out through the mouth. Now take a deep breath. You can do it. In, then out. Take a deep breath, yeah, we're gonna get through it. In through the nose and out through the mouth. We are the dreamers. Wake up and see us. We are the ones who were born to shine with hearts full of hope and healthy minds. We are the dreamers. Wake up and see us. We are the ones who were born to shine with thoughts full of hope and healthy minds. Take a deep breath, y'all.
Thank you, Lucy Joy Bryan, for joining me. Well done. You can take your headphones off and get back to your schoolwork. So the virtual world has opened up for us, and so offer performances in person when possible, but also virtual. And I've got one more song to share with you. And this I would often do at middle schools, and it's got a really catchy chorus that kids really remember. It becomes like a mantra for them when they're feeling discouraged. And it goes like this. You cannot keep me in a box, 'cause I've got the key to the lock. Hey, you cannot keep me in a box, 'cause I've got the key to the lock. And that key is the potential that each kid carries to break out of the bully box, you know, the names that they get called, or the names sometimes that they call themselves when they're feeling down and they feel like they are not living up to what they need to. So this song is meant to encourage you right where you're at, no matter what you're going through. It's gonna be okay, and you've got what it takes to break out of the box and do your own thing, express yourself in all kinds of beautiful and fun ways. It goes like this. Right, y'all. You cannot keep me in a box, 'cause I've got the key to the lock. You cannot keep me in a box, 'cause I've got, yo. I've been in a box, but that box don't fit me. Looking in the mirror like, man, who is he? I'm like Sherlock Holmes solving my mystery, trying to understand who I am through my own history. 'Cause my past is a treasure map, worth more than cash, you can't measure that. I won't let anybody put me in boxes. I'ma be myself, no other options. I've got dreams that I want to see happen, like rapping, I don't care who's laughing. I don't need to be insecure, that means I can like what I like for sure. I don't need to be afraid of what others think, I can like it even if it's a new thing. I got a mind of my own if I'm at school or at home. Now somebody help me sing this poem. It goes, you cannot keep me in a box, 'cause I've got the key to the lock. Yeah, you cannot keep me in a box, 'cause I've got the key to the lock. Do you know where you're from and where you wanna be? Somebody tell me where you at, yeah, you at. Do you know where you at and where you ought to be? Somebody tell me where you at, yo. I'm learning how to use my inner GPS, learning that the one that can see me best, that's me. And I'm trying to figure out for myself what it is that I want to be about. I know I want more than a fantasy, I'm trying to be part of a real family. And there's some heroes right here I can see, living full of love, leaving good legacy. I want to be one of those folks, trying their best and never giving up hope. Even when it gets hard like schoolwork, y'all can make a way through it like DJ Kool Herc, who used music to start a revolution. So I think about the tools that I'm using, my intelligence, my creativity. Put your hands up and sing it with me. It goes, you cannot keep me in a box, 'cause I've got the keys to the lock. Tell them, you cannot keep me in a box, 'cause I've got the key to the lock. Do you know where you're from and where you wanna be? Somebody tell me where you're at. Do you know where you're at? I'm gonna freestyle and just make it up as I go. Yo, I've got a little tale I'm about to unveil. I was at the zoo and I saw a ringtail. It was a lemur jumping all around, up to the sky and down to the ground. I was so inspired, it like lit a fire in my heart. I wanted to learn more, so I had to explore about animals. I had to get down and do my thing. I had to sing a new song, become a vet. In my mind, I didn't want to forget that I fell in love with animal life all around. So I had to get inspired and think, now, how could I do it? Where do I need to go to school so the things that I can read open up before me like pages of a book? I got so inspired that I had to take a look. And that's just an example of something you could be, a vet or even a rapping MC. 'Cause you cannot keep me in a box, 'cause I've got the key to the lock. All right, well done, everybody. That was a little freestyle about someone who wanted to become a vet. And that's an amazing vocation to take on. So great work, everyone. Thanks for participating.
Thank you, Jeremy. I'm just going to jump in here because we actually have three questions for you. I want to make sure that we get to those questions. So the first question is your music available for purchase on CD?
That's a great question. And we sold all out of CDs, which means it's available digitally. Okay. You can download it from bandcamp.com/figureheads.
Okay.
Or you can go to any of your favorite streaming services. That's Apple Music, Spotify, Amazon Music. Wherever you listen to music, if you look up the Figureheads, you'll find a lot of our music streaming and available in that form.
Okay, sounds good. Next question is, so that first question was from Kimberly. Crystal then asks, is it the same price for virtual versus in-person? And if you're doing virtual, can we post it on Facebook or on our website for a certain period of time?
Great question. It's not the same price. Virtual will be about half of the price. So exactly half of everything you see listed in the booklet is what you can expect for virtual. And we can converse about that over email. But exactly half of what you see listed. Yes, the performance can be posted live on Facebook and then recorded and kept up for a time period that we agree upon. So that would be great.
Wonderful. And our final question, and this is from Katie, and it says, might Jeremy present a hybrid program for older kids and teens that is part him performing his raps and part workshop for participants to start working on their own raps and rhymes?
Absolutely. Thank you for asking that. I often bring a live drum machine and I teach the kids how to create their own beats. Using hardware, but also I give them some software options that they could access from any device in terms of composing their own music. And then I help coach a chorus and verses. So a lot of kids, I've recorded over 300 songs with youth, and those can be like anthems for the school, that can be an anthem for the library, or that can just be an anthem for life.
All right, sounds good. One last question. Would you be open to libraries collaborating with other libraries in order to book an in-person performance?
Absolutely.
Okay, wonderful.
I've done that quite often. And then
my last comment is that Lucy was amazing.
Thank you so much.
So I don't know if she can still hear us or not, but tell her that she did a great job. She was fun to watch. Looks like she was really having a good time and she's learned well from her father. So thank you very much. I appreciate that. And so with that, I will say thank you to all three of our performers and to all of the youth librarians who have attended these sessions. And then before we take a quick break, please remember that you can use this same Zoom link to view the rest of the showcases today and tomorrow. And with that, just get up, take a break, have some coffee, get up, answer some emails, do something, stretch your legs. I still have some of Jeremy's songs running through my head, so I'm probably gonna get up and do that. Thank you once again, and we will see you all again at 2:30. Thanks. Bye.